got yourself a crowded shop tonight, Dale.
Yeah, Coach. I think y'all know my wife, Linda, and my daughter, Mary Ellen. Well, I had to talk to Radios. And I told him, not so many words, that we might be looking at some changes. It didn't take long to see, the more I talked, the more he didn't understand me. We got a lot of that going on. When I was playing, I had a coach. He used to tell me to keep my priorities straight. He'd say, son, you figure out what's important, you push everything else aside. I love football. I love everything about it. I love Friday nights when you're looking for a win and Saturday morning when you found one. That's not what's important right now. We got ourselves a young man we're not thinking about. The same young man who could hardly talk when we first met him, and now he's making announcements in the morning on the loudspeaker. Same young man who got himself a football letter last fall, but he never wears it because he can't afford a jacket. Now we're asking him to leave.
Harold, we are not asking.
That's not done, Frank.
I know some of you don't know or don't care about all that Radio's learned over these past few months. But truth is, we're not the ones been teaching Radio. Radio's the one been teaching us. Because the way he treats us all the time is the way we wish we treated each other even part of the time. Look, I know something's got to happen here. I know some change's got to be made. And I know I can't let what happened last season happen again. So I decided to step down as head football coach. Teaching, if that's all right. Keep an eye on Radio and make sure he stays out of trouble. And I'd like to spend a little more time with a few other folks I've neglected over the years while I still have a chance to.